from Hardcore Italians, and you're watching Italian Things with G. Today, we're gonna be going over our blog post titled 13 Things That Happen at Every Italian-American Christmas. Andiamo! If you're Italian, you know that the holidays are filled with great laughter, great food, and love surrounded by your family. So without further ado, I'm gonna give you 13 things that happen at every Italian Christmas. Starting off at number one, you swear you won't fill up on the antipasto, but you always do, okay? It's just so hard, you can't stop. There's prosciutto, and there's the crackers, and there's the cheese, and there's calamari, because it's like seafood, it's Christmas Eve, and it's just, you can't stop. We're in it together, okay? If you have this problem, I feel you. Basically, what I'm trying to say here is you're not alone. Number two, while all your friends are probably just celebrating on Christmas Day, you start celebrating Christmas on Christmas Eve. We're not like the other people who just celebrate on Christmas Day, okay? We start Christmas Eve morning till Christmas, and then even after Christmas, because we got leftovers, of course. Number three, papa or your nonno or whoever makes sure that there's a lot of wine to be had on Christmas Eve through Christmas Day. Because it's a celebration and we're gonna be at that dinner table for a long time, so we're gonna need a lot of vino. Number four, your family probably starts grocery shopping weeks in advance. You know, my family, we're getting like frog legs, pig's feet, you know, we need sepia, we need the lobster, we need the clams, we need all the seafood. Eel is number one on our family's list. You know, that stuff's kind of hard to find, not even because to other people that's a little weird, but to most people, it's not common to get these foods, so we're getting those in a week in advance. If we don't have eel for Christmas, it's not Christmas. We can't, there is no Christmas without the Christmas eel. The food is the most important part of these holidays. I mean, obviously family's the most important, but like, you know what I mean. Come on. What's an Italian holiday without the food? Piggybacking off of number four goes to number five. There is so much fish to be eaten on Christmas and on Christmas Eve. Like I said, we do the eel. I know other families do the Feast of the Seven Fishes. There's shrimp, there's scallops, there's squid, there's calamari. There's a lot of things to be had at the dinner table. And if you're that person in your family who doesn't really prefer seafood, doesn't like the tentacles, doesn't really prefer the calamari, they don't like the squid, the shrimp, the lobster, you're either one of two people. You're either the youngest cousin or you're still that person in the family who likes their pasta with butter and no sauce. Grow up, seafood's amazing. But if you're like allergic to like shellfish or something, you're excused from that. Sorry, I apologize. Number six, cleaning the house starts at least a week in advance. And your mother's going crazy, we're having guests over, and she's like, clean your room. And I'm like, no one's gonna see my room. She's like, I know it's gonna be dirty, clean your room. And I'm like, don't stand in your mother's way during Christmas Eve or Christmas. Number seven, all the adults want you to try to taste the chestnuts, or like they attempt to make chestnuts and they always burn or something. I don't know, this happens in my family. I don't know what it is with the adults and their chestnuts. I'll never like the chestnuts, and I know other families at Christmas do the walnuts, but every male in my family is allergic to walnuts, so we try to do the chestnuts. If you like chestnuts, let me know. I don't know anyone who likes them. I feel like Nana tries to like them just because she doesn't want them to go to waste. Same thing with my mom. Number eight, if you're under the age of 25, you are still sitting at the kids' table at Christmas Eve or at Christmas time. I want you to raise your hand if you're still sitting at the kids' table. Number nine, if you don't get up for seconds, Nana's gonna ask you what's wrong, okay? Because she knows there's a lot of food, she did a lot of work, and if they don't see you get up for seconds, they think that you don't really like their food. So if you wanna see your Nana smile this Christmas, get up for seconds. Number 10, the desserts are unreal for Italian-American Christmases. You know, just a couple weeks before Christmas, the panettone boxes in my house. The amount of panettone in my house during Christmas is unreal. I'm tripping over them. They're everywhere. It's like an infestation of panettone. It's panettone and the bocce chocolate, which bocce chocolate, honestly, is like crack to me. Sometimes I'll be dreaming about it. I'll wake up in the middle of the night and I'll go downstairs and just grab a chocolate. Bocce chocolate is a must at Christmas time. If you go Christmas without having either panettone or bocce chocolate, then did you really celebrate Christmas? Going off of number 10, number 11, everyone has espresso after the meal, and this is where the dunking of the panettone starts. Or it probably started a couple weeks ago because you were getting all those early packages from relatives or from wherever. Maybe your parents just really loved the panettone. They saw it on sale at somewhere and they wanted to bring it home. We're all whipping up the panettone, we're dunking it into the espresso, and we're getting ready to watch a nice Christmas movie. You know, a lot of families watch Christmas movies at Christmas time. I don't know about your family, but my family doesn't really do that. We're more of, oh, it's a holiday, we're all all together, we're watching The Godfather. That's just how it is. I'm gonna be curled up on my couch with like a blanket, my family's around, and we're gonna be watching The Godfather, and I'm gonna see the part where, you know, Michael and Kay are walking through the city, Christmas shopping.
I got something for your mother and for Sunny, and a tie for Freddie, and Tom Hagen got the Reynolds pin.
Yeah. And what do you want for Christmas?
Me? Oh, just you.
Oh, Tom Hagen. Merry Christmas. Hey, I'm glad I run into you. I want to talk to you.
It'll really feel like Christmas when I watch that. And lastly, number 13. The day is full of love, family, and so much laughter that the entire thing starts over again for Christmas Day. So you got Christmas Eve, you got Christmas Day. It's just 2 days full of family and love and food. I mean, what could be better than that? Don't forget to grab a Buon Natale crew neck from Hardcore Italian Store. And don't forget to use my code G, literally just the letter G, for 10% off your entire order. This was Italian Things with G, and thank you so much for watching. Ciao! Thank you.